What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video I'm going to be showing you how to build one of those traditional Asian roofs inside of Revit. So I'm sure you have seen these. They look amazing. They have this sort of a concave surface, and I'm just going to be showing you how to model a complex roof such as this one inside of Revit. Now I'm actually going to be showing you two versions. The first one is just going to be kind of a, where all of the surfaces are curved, and then in the second version I'm just going to be showing you how to have a roof where it actually has tips that kind of curve up. That's going to be a little bit more complicated, but I think it's worth it, and I think it's interesting to learn something like this. Now before we actually jump into Revit, if you're interested in learning more about roofs, all sorts of complex roofs, roof construction and so on, if you want to master roofs in Revit, I have a course on that topic on my website balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. Now, on my website, apart from that course, obviously I have many more different courses that cover different topics inside of Revit. Now, also there you can find some of my ready-to-go customized Revit templates. You can find some really high-quality Revit families, some very realistic Revit families, and we also have a plugin which you might want to check out. Okay, so now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And as you can see, here I am at my home page in Revit. So I'm just going to start a new project. So just go here to Models, go to New, and then I'm just going to set my template file to be Architecture Design Template. Now, as I said, this is one of my templates, and if you want to check it out, I'm just going to leave a link to that also in the description of the video and up in the cards above. Okay, now let's just click OK. That's going to start up Revit. So as soon as Revit starts up, what I'm going to do here is just go to my level 1 floor plan, and then we can just get rid of this starting view. And then in the level 1 floor plan, I'm just going to place some walls. Obviously, we need some walls, so let's go with a rectangle. And then I'm just going to use a simple exterior wall. So we can have a house that looks like this. Hit the escape key a couple of times. So as I said, this will be version 1, so all sides will be curved. And then what you want to do is you want to first of course make sure that it goes up to level 2, which we have here, and then go to reference plane and make sure you place one horizontal reference plane in the middle like so, and then you want to have one vertical reference plane like so. Okay, so this one I'm just going to call it, let's call it NS for north south, and then this one will be called EW for east west. Okay, so let's now come in here and let's actually go and look at this from the east. And then let's come here to our roof, expand this, and we're going to be modeling this as a roof by extrusion. So you just click on that, you set the work plane by name, and then here I'm just going to set this to east west. Click OK. And then let's set it at level 2, click OK again. And now I'm just going to be using simple arcs. So just a simple arc, go like that, and then give it that concave shape. Hit the escape key a couple of times. You can then select this, go to mirror, back access, MM is the shortcut. Mirror it to the other side, hit the escape key a couple of times, and then just hit finish. Then you can go to the 3D view, and here this might be a bit too thick, so you can reduce it. So I'm just going to set this to 20 centimeters, and then you can just place that roof like so. So what I'm going to do here is, actually I'm just going to measure the overhang here. So if I just measure this, so let's see how much to the wall. So that's 86.62. So I can just copy that number, go here, and then let's go into level, no, let's go to the site plan here, and then what I'll do is I can just place a reference plane. That will probably be the easiest thing to do. So just a couple of reference planes like this. Then let's go into level 1, and then here just paste that value. So 86.62, same thing goes here. Okay, and then when you go to your site plan, you can just extend the roof up to that point, so the overhang will be the same on both sides. Okay, so now we just want to carve this out because we want it to to go in all four directions. So you just go back to the site plan and then you go to vertical opening. You select the roof and then you can simply come in here and create that opening like so. And then let's reduce this. Can we do two at once? Let's see, or I can just grab this one and then mirror that around this axis. Okay, finish. There we go, perfect. So what you'll notice, it's going to look like this. Now what we want to do is we want to go to the south elevation here, and then again you're just going to go to roof, oops, not that one. Go to roof by extrusion. Okay, pick a work surface or work plane. This one is going to be north south. Okay, click OK, level 2, that's fine. And then you just want to use pick lines and just pick this line. Or let's see, can we do both at once? No, it's not going to let us. So let's delete this one and hit finish. Okay, and let's set it to 20. Okay, perfect. Go to the 3D view and let's see what that looks like. So it's going to be too small in this case, so you just extend it here. Okay, it's not going to snap. So let's go to site plan and then let's extend it up to here and up to here. And now let's cut it. So again, vertical opening, and then you just want to cut it like this. So you can just make a cut like so, and then, yeah. So just connect it here. So just make sure that this isn't touching this point. So just give it a little bit of offset and then hit finish. Perfect. And then we can just mirror this to the other side by the pick axis. And there we go. So now we have this type of a roof, and I think it looks really, really cool. So I'm quite happy with this result. Okay, so now for part two, for the second version, I'm just going to be showing you how to make sure that these kind of tips here flare upwards, and that's sort of the harder one. Okay, so now for the second version, I'm going to be starting off with this roof type, and then only the edges are going to be kind of flaring up at kind of a diagonal angle. So what I'll do first is I'll just make sure to kind of take out the corners here, so to just make room for our flared edges. So let's go to the site plan here, and then I'm just going to select this edge, go to edit footprint, and then I'll just straighten this out like so. Do the same thing on the other side, just like that, hit finish, and then I'm just going to fix this one. So here I can just delete these corner or these diagonal edges, and then just use trim and extend to corner to fix this up like so. And then finally for the other side, I'm just going to do the same thing that I did previously, which just means straightening out these edges. And now what we have is basically a roof where we can kind of play around with these edges here, or with these corners here, and flare them up. So what I'll do next is just go here to Massing and Site, turn on Show Mass, and go to InPlace Mass, because this is going to be modeled as an InPlace Mass. Okay, so now here, as you can see here, I've been just testing this a little bit, so I'm just going to delete these, and then I'll show you kind of from the beginning. So let's go here to the site plan, and then I'm just going to create this corner here, and then we're just going to be copying that. So what you want to do here is, oops, let's see, okay, I guess we got rid of that mass. Okay, so here you just want to first place some reference planes, which are just going to make things easier for you. So let's place one here, and then you can extend it like so. Then you want to go place another one here. This one is going to be a host, that's important. This one is also going to be a host, so that one is also important. So let's call this one number one. Okay, so we already have a number one, I guess. So let's call this one A1. Okay, this one is going to be called A3. And then for A2, that's going to become here in the middle. So let's go to reference plane and then place one here in the middle. And then just to make sure that the distances are equal, let's go here to dimension, place a dimension like so. Turn on EQ just to equalize these, and then we can delete the dimension. Okay, now let's see, let's go here back to reference plane, place one here at the 45 degree angle, which is just going to help us. and then place one here, just kind of marking out this spot. So we kind of created some sort of basically a base here just to start with. And then this one is going to be, as I said, A2. So we have A1, A2, A3. Okay, so having set all of that up, now I can come in here. So this is on the west side. So let's open up the west elevation. And then here, I just want to come in here and use the spline through points tool. You want to set this at A1 first, click OK. And then what you want to do here is basically just set these. Oops, I think I should have added one more reference plane. So let me hit the escape key a couple of times and add just a reference plane here. Perhaps one here and one here, just because it's going to make things a bit easier. Okay, so back to our spline through points. Make sure that the drawn work plane is selected and then the reference plane is set to A1. You click once here, then you're just going to click a couple of more times here, and then we can kind of take it up a little bit, and then let's flare it up like so. So it's really up to you kind of how high you want to go with this. So you can also go to the 3D view just to see where that is. So for example, this one is good, but perhaps this one in the middle can go up a little bit like that. Okay, so I'm happy with the way that this turned out. So let's go back to our west elevation. And then let's repeat that. So here for the second one, basically I'm just going to go here to spline through points, click a couple of times here, then go here. And then finally we can go up to here. So you basically just want to go up to this reference plane here, and then you don't want to go too crazy. Let's see, just like that. So, and then we can just go to the 3D view and just to see how that looks, what's going on there. So here, as you can see, I think I've made a mistake. So this is on the wrong reference plane. So just to fix this, what I'll do is I can just delete this and then just draw that again. So when you draw this spline for the second one, you want to go to A2. So there we go. Let's just repeat that. Something like so. Okay, happy with that. And then finally here, you just want to have a few of them really close together. So just going to zoom in here and then place it like that. Let's see. Can bring this in. Nope. So sometimes it's not going to let you move these too close together. Is this going to work? No. How about no? And let's actually start over. So let's see. So the last one is the tricky one. So you can kind of try to see how much you zoom in. You don't want to zoom in too much. Okay, so reference plane A3, then you click, and then you click here. So you just want to do something like that. So something that's really kind of close together. You can even move it in. So as you can see, it's less than a centimeter, and you just don't want to make sure it doesn't go too far or here out of this axis. Okay, let's then go to the 3D view, and now you just want to select this line, hold the control key, select this line, hold the control key and select this line and zoom out, and then click on create form, which is going to create this form. And as you can see, we have that flared edge. So once we have this, we're pretty much done. So I like to stop that here. Then you go to masking and site, you go to roof, you pick out this roof, for example. Okay. So sometimes it's not going to work depending on either the thickness of the roof or it's with the geometry. So sometimes you have to make some small modifications. So I'm not sure what's causing the issue here. So it might be these up here. So you can always go back to edit in place. You can select this. I like to go here to X-ray just to see what's going on here. And then you can kind of just select these and then move them around a little bit. So I'm just going to move this off to the side, just extending it a little bit. So let's hope this solves our issue. Hit finish. And then we can try again. So let's go here to roof. There we go. So as you can see here, it worked. So it was just a matter of changing it a little bit. Will it work with a larger one? No. So it's only going to work with a smaller one, but that's okay. We can just make all of these smaller as well. So let's set that to 20 centimeter, and then let's give it an offset up. So we just have to move it up to this point here. So let's go to the west elevation. Okay, move. And then you just want to move it up here. Okay, perfect. Okay, so once you have all of this in place, then it's just a matter of mirroring this. So you just go to your site plan. You come here, and then you want to mirror this here, just kind of diagonally. So you can do that by placing some reference planes to help out. So I just like to come here to, we can just go like that. Find here the kind of the intersection of that. Perfect. Select this, mirror back access, mirror it around. There we go. Then select these two. Oops, so it only mirrored the massing, I think. Okay, so let's come in here and place the roof. Let's see, escape out of this. Okay, so roof. There we go. So now if we only select the roofs, go to the site plan, and then it's just a matter of mirroring that. So let's mirror it like this, and then go to the 3D view. Hold the control key, select these two again, go back to the site plan, and then go to draw mirror again, just like that. And now we have exactly that roof that we were looking for. So as you can see, we have those edges that are flaring up. So it's not perfect, but this is a really complex roof type. So this is usually the best that we can get by using the Revit kind of in-place massing. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you want to get these project files, you can find all of my Revit project files on my Patreon page. So I'm just going to include a link to that in the description of this video, and then also up in the cards above. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.